Are you a developer or data analyst who regularly gets the question, can I see more details? Or can I download this to Excel? Well, your search is over. In this episode of McCoy TV, I'll explain how you can look into detailed information with the SAP Analytics Cloud Data Analyzer. My name is Kris from Brouwershaven, business intelligence consultant at McCoy. I've been working with SAP Analytics Cloud for over 2 years, and in this episode of McCoy TV, I'll explain how you can look into detailed information with the SAP Analytics Cloud Data Analyzer. With the Data Analyzer, you have the possibility to look at your models and sources in a pivot table, all within the SAP Analytics Cloud portal. The Data Analyzer gives the user the possibility to leverage a pivot table to filter and analyze data. These analyses can be saved and shared within the SAP Analytics Cloud portal, which enables easy access to the analysis for recurring questions or sharing insights. The functionality of the Data Analyzer is quite similar to the pivot table functionality in Analysis for Office or the SAC Office add-in in Excel. Now it's time to look at the Data Analyzer. The Data Analyzer has been made generally available within the app menu. Beforehand, it was only available when you installed an application. In the Data Analyzer, you have the option to connect directly to a data source or an existing model. You can also view and share other analysis files. Let's connect to an existing model. The benefit of using a model is that you can use the structures and calculations defined in the model. For example, you can group your dimensions, you can add delta calculations and many more things in your model, which you can then use in your Data Analyzer. The Data Analyzer creates your table in real time. So if I select or deselect certain measures, the table reflects that. And this resembles the standard way of working with a pivot table. And by selecting these measures, filters, and dimensions, the table starts changing and your analysis is taking shape. Now that we have our table, the next step is to use a filter to sort the data. This works the exact same way as you're used to in your SAP Analytics Cloud dashboards. You press this filter button and you select your dimensions. Also, I'd like to apply some sorting to my table, and this is how you do it. And once you're satisfied with the result and you want to check this Data Analyzer file more often, you can simply save it. When you return to the Data Analyzer in the app menu, you can see the file we just created. Once again, you can easily share it here as well. Sometimes a user or yourself simply wants to look at the data in Excel. That's also covered within the Data Analyzer. Simply go to these three dots, select Export, and you can export it in the file type you like. Note that the size export gives you a warning message when the size exceeds 500 rows. You can only change this when the appropriate message appears. And there you have it. This is how you can work with Data Analyzer. It's a handy tool to complement your ad hoc data analysis. And it also ensures you don't have to leave the SAP Analytics Cloud portal anymore. Are your hands itching to work with this, but you like a bit more guiding? Let us know. We're happy to help. Please consider leaving a like and subscribe to our channel, since it helps us a lot. If you have any questions, please let them know in the comments or contact us. I hope you learned something new. Thanks for watching.